Hi guys, my name is Anuj Jindal. Welcome to this session on Companies Act. So this session is going to be relevant for students who are preparing for SEBI examination specifically, because Companies Act is a part of the syllabus of only SEBI and not RBI. So students preparing for SEBI 2020, this is the session relevant for those guys. Okay. So if you have not yet done Companies Act, or even if you have done and if you want to revise, and chapter 21, which is related with appellate tribunal and the tribunal in general, then this session is going to be relevant for you. Before starting with the session, I wish to take you across to the website once, because a lot of students keep asking this query again and again about the courses, about the website. Whatever updations are also made on the website, I will try and share those with you as well. So on the website, you can take a free trial, and there is a daily timetable for both RBI and SEBI, which is running around here. So you can, which is hovering around here. So you can download it from here for free. Okay. If there is something new that has been added and I want to show it to you, if you are preparing for any of these examinations, RBI, SEBI, NABARD, or even UGC NET, and if you are here by mistake, then you can see all the topper videos right here. Okay. So on the homepage, when you click on Hall of Fame, you will be taken to this new page, which has been created, which has all the videos in one page that will be relevant for you, because it will help you understand what are the strategies that toppers adopted or used, which made sure that they cleared the examination. Now coming to the courses. There are multiple courses for RBI as well as SEBI. There is one complete course for phase 1 as well as phase 2, which costs 19,000, which is going to be useful for RBI 2020 as well as for 2021, because 2021 is going to get 2020 has got delayed, and therefore there will be a little gap between these two examinations. There is a 15% discount going on right now. Please make sure that you use the code. A lot of students forget to use the code, and they get back to us after realizing that they've made this mistake. If you are sure that you can clear phase 1 quant reasoning and English on your own, if you're writing other banking examinations, then you can very well go for phase 1 GA and phase 2 complete, which is cheaper. Then there is a course for phase 1 only, and then there are other courses which are specific for finance management as well as ESI, depending upon needs of the students. Then there are some courses for SEBI. There is complete crash course for phase 1 and phase 2, which is for 18,000. Similar discounts are going on, and whenever there is a festival, the next one will be, I believe, Christmas and New Year. There will be discounts that then as well. Okay. Then for legal, if you're preparing specifically for legal paper, then there is a collaboration kind of a thing with Law Digest. You can visit that channel as well on YouTube. Ma'am has created a beautiful course, which is only a PDF course for the legal aspirants, okay, for SEBI. And then there is a course only for paper 2. If you feel then that you are going to be able to clear paper 1 on your own, that is quant reasoning, English and GA, then you can take only the paper 2 course as well. Now coming back to the session. So today, as I said, we'll be covering chapter 27, that is on NCLT tribunal and the appellate tribunal. If you're coming here for the first time, do not forget to subscribe to the channel. That gives me that dopamine hit that I need in order to keep coming out with these beautiful sessions for you guys. Let's start with the first question, which says, which of the following persons can become president of National Company Law Tribunal, NCLT, and not NCLAT? Please remember that. That is where the examiner can play with you as per provisions of Companies Act 2013. Who among the following can become president of NCLT? The options are here in front of you. Suman, who has been a judge of Supreme Court for 2 years. Now, these are specific: judge, not chief justice, Supreme Court, not High Court, and 2 years. Neha, who has been a judge of High Court for 5 years. 5 years, High Court, judge. These are the keywords. So keep highlighting these keywords in your mind as well when you are actually writing the final examination or any of the mocks. Brijesh, who is in his third year, that means he's completed 2 years as judge of High Court. Okay. Sukanya, who is in her seventh year, that means she's completed 6 years as judge of another tribunal court, and Kunal, who has been a judge at a district court for 7 years. Who among the following can become not a member, president of NCLT? Okay, president of NCLT. So you have to answer this question. Keep answering it. Either you can have a page and you can write down whatever option you feel is correct, because this is not a live session. This is a recorded session that I'm holding for you guys, so that the process of preparing for the examination towards the end can be sped up. Okay. Now the answer to this question is B, Neha, who has been a judge of High Court for 5 years. You need to be at least be a judge of High Court for 5 years. The president of NCLT shall be a person who is or has been a judge of High Court for 5 years. Okay, so remember this. This is the specific provision that you need to keep in mind. Okay, let's come to the second question. The second question is, a list of candidates and their qualifications is provided below. Analyze the qualifications carefully and see which of the candidates is or are eligible to become technical member of NCLT. So NCLT has a president. NCLT has members who can be divided into two parts, judicial members and technical members. Okay. Here specifically, we are talking only about the eligibility for technical members and not judicial members. So remember that as well. You have to remember a lot of things in Companies Act, but once you have covered everything and once you remember everything, it becomes very, very easy. Okay. Naresh has been a practicing CA, chartered accountant, for the past 20 years. Nandita has been in the field of industrial finance for the past 10 years. These are the keywords. Nisha has been a joint secretary, JSEC, of Indian Legal Service for 2.5 years. Another keyword. And fourth is Sunny, no qualification provided. So we have to identify who among the following is qualified or eligible to become a technical member of NCLT. Okay, post your answers either in the comment below or on a piece of paper. You can just write your answer, whatever you think is correct. These are the options available. The answer to this question is B, only Naresh is eligible, who has been practicing as a chartered accountant for 20 years. We will understand the reasons as well why 2, 3 and 4 are not eligible. Okay, the reasons are mentioned here. You have to remember these provisions by heart. It says, conditions for appointment of a person as a technical member of NCLT are a member of Indian Corporate Law Service or Indian Legal Service for 15 years. So Corporate Law Service and Legal Service or any one of them for 15 years. Out of which at least 3 years in the pay scale of JSEC. So because another option was there where a person had been working as a JSEC for 2.5 years. That's why not eligible, because minimum eligibility is 3 years as a JSEC, joint secretary. Okay. Practicing CA, CS, CWA, any of these three for at least 15 years. That's why Naresh is eligible. A person having special knowledge and experience of at least 15 years in industrial finance or law. Another person had an experience of only 10 years, and that's why Nandita was not eligible. Okay. A presiding officer of a labor court or tribunal for at least 5 years. So presiding court, presiding officer hona chahiye law, labor court ka ya tribunal ka for at least 5 years. That is the fourth eligibility. Please try and remember them, because the questions are going to be hovering around these options, these provisions only for sure. Okay. Let's come to the third question for today. The question says, what is the maximum number of judicial and technical members? Maximum number of judicial and technical members that can be appointed to NCLAT. Now we are talking about appellate tribunal at a given point in time. Now there is no limit for National Company Law Tribunal, but there is a limit in the appellate tribunal. Okay. Post your answers either in the comment section below or mention it, write it down on a piece of paper. I'm saying it again. The answer to this question is A11, a very factual question, a one marker. I can very well say that it's very relevant question for phase 1 paper 2 specifically. It says here specifically what has been mentioned in the act. The central government shall constitute NCLAT consisting of chairperson and such member of judicial and technical members not exceeding 11. So chairperson, judicial member, technical member, all three of them should not combinedly exceed 11. One chairperson, that means a total of 10 technical members plus judicial members. Okay, so this is the third answer. Let's come to the question number 4. That was a factual question, therefore no explanation, detailed explanation required. Which of the following authorities is consulted with before the appointment of president of NCLT and chairperson of NCLAT? Very, very important. Who among the following authorities is or are consulted before appointing the president and chairperson of NCLT and NCLAT? The options are DM, Chief Justice of India, President of India, Prime Minister of India, Vice President of India. Very, very relevant question. I can say it's a one marker and very high chances that such questions are going to be asked in the examination from you, specifically in phase 1, paper 2 of SEBI. The answer to this question is B, Chief Justice of India. Let's go into the details. I have some additional information as well for you. So, ye additional information bahut kaam ki aapke liye. It's going to be very useful. Do not miss out on this. Okay, you can keep writing this additional information if you don't know it already on a piece of paper, or if you know it, it will be a good revision for you. Okay. Appointment of the president of NCLT and chairperson and judicial members of NCLAT is done after consultation with Chief Justice. So, not only the chairperson and the president, but also judicial members, not technical members. We're talking only about technical judicial members. So, yahan pe dono ka differentiation samajhna zaruri hai. It's important to understand the differentiation. President of NCLT, chairperson of NCLAT and judicial members, these three combined, in teenon ko combine karke, agar hum bole to consultation is done only with the Chief Justice of India. Chief Justice of India. Okay. What about the technical members? The members of tribunal and technical members of appellate tribunal. So, members of tribunal and technical members of the appellate tribunal. So, here we are talking about only judicial members of NCLAT only and not NCLT. So, all the members of NCLT and technical members of NCLAT shall be appointed on the recommendation of who? A selection committee is created for that. Who is the chairperson of the selection committee? Chief Justice of India or his nominee. So, instead of consulting only the Chief Justice of India, now we are consulting what? A selection committee. Who is the head chairperson of selection committee? Chief Justice of India, or he can nominate some person. There are some members also. A senior judge of Supreme Court or Chief Justice of High Court needs to be a member. Secretary of Ministry of Corporate Affairs, Secretary in Ministry of Law and Justice, Secretary in Department of Financial Services, Ministry of Finance. The Secretary, Ministry of Corporate Affairs shall be the convener of the selection committee. Isko bhi yaad rakhna hai. Convener kaun hoga selection committee ka? Secretary of Ministry of Corporate Affairs. So, Secretary kaha kaha ke? Ministry of Corporate Affairs, Ministry of Law and Ministry of Finance. In teen ke Secretary, then we have Senior Judge of Supreme Court or Chief Justice of High Court, and the Chairperson of Chief Justice of Supreme Court or his nominee. Any nominee that he appoints. Okay. Let's come to the next question. I hope it's clear now. Question number 5 pe aate hain. Which of the following is true with regard to eligibility for a person to be appointed as the chairperson of NCLAT? NCLAT ka chairperson hone ke liye, in order to be appointed as chairperson of NCLAT, what is the eligibility? This is the question. Very simple. The chairperson should be an advocate practicing for more than 20 years. Advocate 20 years, keyword over. Advocate 20 years. The chairperson should be a Chief Justice of High Court. Number 2. The chairperson should be a judge of the High Court. Number 3. The chairperson should be a judge of Supreme Court. Number 4. Judge, Supreme Court, Judge, High Court, Chief Justice, High Court, advocate practicing for more than 20 years. That is number 4. We have to identify which of the following is the correct answer. Eligible kaun kaun hai? Okay. Mention it either again in the comment section ya fir ek page pe likh lo. Why am I repeating this again and again? Because if you don't answer it yourself before I answer it for you, then you will not be able to learn from your mistakes. Because you will not make any mistakes. Aap mistake karoge nahi, paper pe likhoge nahi, you will not realize that you have made a mistake. Okay. The answer to this question is both 2 and 4, that is D, chairperson should be a Chief Justice of High Court, chairperson should be a judge of Supreme Court. Judge High Court ka nahi chalega, Chief Justice hona zaruri hai, advocate nahi chalega, okay? Let us go through the details. The chairperson of appellate tribunal can be a judge of Supreme Court or Chief Justice of High Court. Only these two people are eligible to be chairperson of appellate tribunal. Okay, I hope it's clear now. Next question pe aate hain. Sixth question for today. Which of the following statements are false? Now we are not asking true statement. Please don't make this mistake. I am asking you false statement with regard to age up to which appointees can hold office in NCLT or NCLAT. Age ki baat ho rahi hai and we are talking about false statements. Kaun si inme se false statement hai with regard to age up to which somebody can become appointee as a member or a president in NCLT or NCLAT. The president of the tribunal can hold office until the age of 65 years. A member of appellate tribunal can hold office until 65 years. A member of tribunal can hold office until the age of 67 years. Teen cheezein yahan pe di hui hain. President 65, tribunal. Member appellate tribunal 65. Member tribunal 67 years. You have to identify which of the following are false statements and not true statements. Okay. I hope you have written your answer in your notebooks or in the comments below. Please likho answer ko, write down the answers. Likhoge nahi, if you don't pen it down, if you don't write down your thoughts, your mind will keep telling you that it's right to make mistakes or you've not even made a mistake. Okay. So please don't do that to yourself. Don't fool yourself. The answer to this question is D. All the statements are false. All the statements are false. And there are high chances ki yahan se question aayega hi aayega. Both in phase 1 as well as in phase 2 of SEBI, very high chances that you will have one or more questions from this specific area. A member in a tribunal, not appellate tribunal, can hold office till he turns 65 years of age. And the president can hold till he is 67 years. So member tribunal may 65, president 67. In the appellate tribunal, member is 67 and chairperson 70. See, it's very easy to remember. So you have first of all chairperson in the appellate tribunal, right? Then you have members in the appellate tribunal, right? Then you have president in the tribunal, and then you have members in the tribunal, and the age is also in the descending order. 70, 67, 67 and 65. This way you can easily remember this. Ye aapko koi nahi batayega, something that I've told you, jisse aapko bahut clarity milegi. This will help you remember this entire thing. Otherwise, you'll keep trying to mug it up and you will realize ki yaad hi nahi ho raha hai. You're not able to remember this small information. Next question pe aate hain. One of the most simple questions for today, I believe. Where does the principal bench of NCLT operate in India? A one marker for phase 1 paper 2. One of the most important questions, simple question, but aise questions aayenge exam mein. These kinds of questions are going to be asked in the examination for sure. Okay. The answer to this question is A, New Delhi. New Delhi mein hai principal bench of NCLT, presided over by the president of the tribunal. Isme koi, there is no nothing to explain in this. Next question pe aate hain. Within what time period can the NCLT amend any order passed by it in order to rectify any mistake? NCLT has passed an order. Now it realizes that it has made a mistake indeed. Within how much time can it amend its own order? Kitne time mein wo apna order amend kar sakta hai? This is another one marker for SEBI. More important for phase 1, of course, can be asked in phase 2 as well, but more relevant for phase 1. The answer to this question is, I hope you have noted down your answer, C, 2 years. Within 2 years from the date of the order, NCLT can amend the order passed by it in order to rectify any mistake. Okay. Ninth question pe aate hain, another factual question. Smita is aggrieved by the order of the tribunal. She is suggested by her friends to refer the appeal to the appellate tribunal. So she wants to appeal in the appellate tribunal. However, there is a time limit within which she can refer the appeal to the NCLAT. What is that time period within which she would be allowed to do so. Within how much time can a person, in short, appeal or go to the appellate tribunal if he or she is not satisfied with the decision of the NCLT, that is tribunal? Kitne time mein aap ja sakte hain? The answer to this question, I hope you have mentioned it. C, 45 days. Within 45 days from the date on which a copy of the order is made available to the aggrieved person. मुझे आज कॉपी मिली है, आज से 45 दिनों के अंदर अंदर, within 45 days from today that I have received a copy of the order, I can go to the appellate tribunal. I hope it's clear. Simple question, factual question है, right? Last question पे आते हैं. Another factual question, and I believe last question for today. The question says, a tribunal or appellate tribunal must deal and dispose of every petition. Now this is time limit on passing an order. That was going to the appellate tribunal. This is time limit which is applicable on the tribunal or on the appellate tribunal itself. Ki itne din mein aapko order pass karna hai, within these many days or months, you have to dispose of any petition, dispose of any problem that has come to you. Okay. Within a period of 3 months, the tribunal or appellate tribunal must deal and dispose of every petition from the date of its presentation. However, this period can be extended. Ye period extend kiya ja sakta hai in certain situations which are not specified in the act. What is the time limit for the extension? For how much time period can this order be extended? What is the maximum time limit? The answer is very simple. 3 months is the first limit. The next limit is also 3 months. What is 3 months? 90 days. Okay. So 90 days is the answer, option E here. Okay, so 3 months, 3 months, I think it's very easy for you to remember this now. So this was the session which was to be held on, or which was supposed to be there on NCLT and NCLAT. Very important session, I must tell you. There are expected to be at least 2 to 3 questions from law tribunal or appellate tribunal in both phase 1 and phase 2 of SEBI. So be assured that you're prepared well. It's very, very simple to remember it. Ek chote se paper pe likh lo, write down all the facts on a small piece of paper in shortcuts, and you will be able to revise it well before the examination. Okay. All the very best, guys. Take care. Bye-bye.